Hear a bit of bird song coming in the door. I'm in, well, what is quite a significant investment. I'm inside the newly positioned and refurbished lodge at Edenbrook Fishery, and I'm just looking lovingly at an image where someone has photographed the fish, but not the person holding the fish. There's plenty of other really cool images. Look at that Fraisson one. I have to tell you, the smell of new fresh timber in here is just delicious. Although I gather, according to Mr. Chris Gould, governor, owner, factotum here, that there's going to be the aroma of bacon sandwiches in here before long. Is that the case, Chris? And hello, of course, hello, mate.
Yes, that's correct. Yes, yes.
Tell us a little bit about Edenbrook, because I know that you're a well-managed and essentially appointments-type fishery. Like, gosh, it's the way that very large one with all the predators in it has gone. First off, how many lakes have you got here?
We've got two lakes.
And they're called?
The original lake, the Edenbrook Lake, which has been here about 21 years.
You dug yourself.
And, yes, that's correct. And we've got the Meridian Lake, which has been here for about 9 years, which is often used for matches and day tickets as well.
And the day ticket here costs?
£11 for 3 rods.
Gotcha, that's keen. Especially with, that's jolly topical for 2016, because there seem to be developments. Well, I think it's going to happen. We're going to end up with 3 rods on 1 licence. And your membership, well, you were saying, was £30 a year, and that gets you £1 off per day tickets. £1 off per day ticket. So if you are here every single week, you're £20 up by the end of the year.
That's correct.
Yes, and you have lots and lots of regulars. Tell us about your stock. What's actually in here? I said last time I was here, there were 100 fish being put in that were freshly stocked.
Yeah, well,
spent some money on some carp.
Yeah. The stock has stayed mainly the same, although they've been breeding in the last 2 years.
Oh, you've got little ones.
Yeah, well, we had it netted this year.
All right.
So we've moved a lot of the small ones from the Edenbrook Lake through onto the Meridian Lake.
Turning it more match-like.
Yes.
Yes.
So there's a big head of stock in there now.
Oh, wow.
So Excellent. Let's move that on a bit.
Okay, well, without further ado, because I think they want to see the waters, don't they? There's people watching this on trains. Lovely lodge. We'll go photograph it from the outside and go nag some poor angler to photograph the back of his head for the magazine. Chris, thanks ever so much. Here we go.
Okay, I've picked a strategic place outside. You're looking at the front of a rather fabulous balcony on the front of the lodge and the end of a rather cute roof on a... Well, that's the shower and loo block, looking terribly rustic and lovely. There's the cars. In the distance, that's Meridian Lake. And the size of that lodge we've just been in, awesome. And just on the pillar top right here, looks like this was a fountain once, Chris. I lied to you. I said I wasn't going to put you on camera, but here we are. He said, was that once on a fountain?
Could well have been.
He's got astronauts. Where'd you find him? Just somewhere on your travels?
Yeah, like just those... somewhere on my travels, that's right, yeah. And he's been at home here now for about 10 years.
Brilliant. Some lovely chunks of like rock and all kinds of things, like Portland and things where there was a stone hole carved in it in the masonry going up to your lodge stairs there, safely above a decent bit of flood level, this being flood plain and all. This is Edenbrook Lake. Of course, it's winter time. I have driven through a whole bunch of fog just now, but thank God. It's just a soft dove grey, and unlike so many fisheries, it's quiet. Those blokes are going to bloody die. I have not asked their permission. The one on the right clearly has a wet arse. Sorry. Tell them they're going to be famous on the internet, on Angus Mail TV, and all their mates can take the rip. I'm going to zoom back before Blokey. Before Blokey has a little scratch. Anyway. Tell us about the fish in this lake, sir.
Yeah, well, the stock stays mainly the same in this lake. There's a stock of about 100 fish from... £8 through to £35.
£35? That's a... You said a... So how many 30s do you reckon you got in here, Governor? There's places that show off about the numbers of 30s they have in.
There would only be two or three in the 30s.
Only two or three 30s in here, gentlemen. So only. Only. And this is not a heavily pressurised water. This is... this is a place where you have to make appointments, so you don't get loads of noddies throwing rocks in here, do you? Just letting that sink in. Any of them got any names, Mr. Gord?
Not to my knowledge.
No, you're not a believer in naming them.
No.
But there's some photographs on the wall that I should have recognised, of course, that, yeah. Especially the way that had been lovingly photographed. There was me taking the rip out the way the thing had been photographed, because it was a loving image, essentially, of the fish. Yes. Okie doke. Well,
We'll just pop over there and get a little shot of Meridian as well, so you can have a look at quite how sumptuous that flipping balcony is up there. And apologies for the name of the Renault. Okay, here we go. Yeah, it's got to be said, there's some lodges I've seen builded in fishing, but that is a beast. Check out. Ooh, balcony up there. In Emel, of course, we've just come down. Oh, bit of a fast zoom. Just come down here. There's the Edenbrook Lake. I'm just going to zoom straight past here. So a quick hello to Chris and I pass. Right, Chris.
Yep.
And zoom over the heads of the happy spectators here who didn't bargain for the snutter with the camera. And come down and find young Tom here. Right, geese?
All right, mate.
So what's your best out of this here lake then?
This lake, my biggest out of here is 14 pound, and out of the Edenbrook Lake, 24.
Oh, dude. That's 10 pounds above my PB.
Yeah.
Yeah. I've obviously spent a lot of time chasing it, but...
Yeah, it does take a while to get the bigger fish out, to be fair. I mean, I've had 3 20s out of Edenbrook Lake, but and there's other people that have had a lot more, you know?
Uh-huh. So, excellent.
Yeah, they're all they're in there, but it's just a matter of finding them. Today's not been my day.
Oh.
But normally I do quite well, so... Chris knows, I always have a fit.
It's alright, chap, you don't have to make excuses. On the Angler's Mail's Angler Mail TV tactical briefings thing, my particular camera, I'm afraid, has a thing called the curse of the Angler's Mail camera, which means if you were in, you're screwed anyway. You would lose it, because I grapple on about it too much, but yeah, it's not even funny. I don't one day want it to be some monstrous great fish and spung because fat bloke had the camera on you.
Hopefully not.
Yes, in other words, go away. Yes. Lovely, peaceful location here, though. I've just been looking at the lake, but... Okay, a bit of an aeroplane, but... Edenbrook Farm. Tucked away a little bit here, in the countryside. Membership fishery. You actually have to stop, open the gate, and then go through it, and then close it, like proper grown-ups in the countryside and everything here. Yeah. It's how you know you're at one of the better establishments, isn't it?
Yeah.
Absolutely. It just remains for me to ask the viewer to... Follow us on Facebook and love us up on Twitter, or was that the other way around? I can't remember. All right, Tom, cheers, mate.
No problem.
And in classic fat bloke tradition, I've said a sumptuous goodbye and then tacked a bit on the end. That is an engraved... Ooh, what do you think? Isn't it beautiful? It's on... Well, apparently there's 3 grand's worth of glass on this here balcony. Just wish it was a summer's evening and we could all be sat up there having a meditative end of day. Cup, a pint, whatever, and a bacon sarnie. Lovely place, Edenbrook Fishery. Bit wet today. Finally signing out. Adam Renner, Angler's Mail TV.